What's up guys, this is Shihab and this is my review of Samsung Galaxy J6. So it's an entry to mid-range phone, so you should not expect very high-end features or high-end performance with it. So let's start with the design. It has a plastic build, but the glossy and shiny look gives you a feel that it looks like a glass back. But due to that glossy look, it looks expensive than what it is. Though it's a typical Samsung design, but it follows the 2018 18:9 aspect ratio, so it looks modern and a little bit futuristic. So up front you are getting a 18:9 or 2:1 aspect ratio display. Nothing very fancy at the front and at the back. At the back you have your typical camera and fingerprint sensor. So at the bottom you have your USB and 3.5mm headphone jack, but no USB Type-C. The top is clean. At the left side you have your volume rocker, micro SD slot, dual SIM slot, and at the right side you have your power button and a tiny speaker, which is not very good sounding. In terms of design, I will give 4 out of 5 because it's a budget phone, and though this phone doesn't have any premium material to it, but it looks good from outside due to its glossy finish. Now let's talk about that tall display. It's a typical Samsung Super AMOLED display with 720p resolution, and the display size is 5.6 inch, and the pixel per inch is 293. If it had a previous 16:9 aspect ratio, the PPI would have gone a little bit lower, but due to the taller aspect ratio, the PPI is near 300 pixel per inch, or the Apple's Retina standard. Still, you will see some individual pixels if you really want to see them, but other than that, it's a really good display and most of the time you will not have any complaint. I'm not talking anything about the color and contrast of this Samsung AMOLED display because those are already good. Now let's talk about the performance. It has Exynos 7870 chip, which is built with a 14 nanometer architecture, and the CPU is Octa-core Cortex A53, which has a 1.6 GHz clock speed. All the 8 cores are running at 1.6 GHz and this will improve the battery life. Talking of battery, it has 3000 mAh battery, and in my testing, the battery life is pretty good. The GPU in this phone is Mali T830MP1. It has SD card slot and it comes with two memory sizes, 64GB internal memory with 4GB of RAM and 32GB of internal memory with 3GB of RAM. In terms of performance, it's a good phone. Day-to-day task is fluent, like Facebooking, watching YouTube videos, or scrolling in Instagram. These kind of things, tasks are really fluent, and gaming performance is, I will say, medium. Not so high because obviously you're not paying that much, but I can say we can play pretty much all the games. I have tried PUBG, it runs smoothly, though I have to adjust some of the graphic settings. Now let's talk about the cameras. It has a 13 megapixel rear shooter with f1.9 aperture, and the rear camera shoots 1080p videos at 30 frames per second. The front camera is 8 megapixel with f1.8 aperture. The rear camera shoots decent photos at good lighting. In daylight and outdoors, the photos are quite good. It's really good if you want to use them in social media. The front facing selfie camera is also good, and I like the selfie camera a lot because the colors and the wide lens really makes it up. Now the conclusion time. When the phone first launched, it launched with a price tag of $200, but now it's like November or December, it dropped price quite a bit, so you can get it around like 160. In Bangladeshi taka it was like over 22,000, and now you can get it I think within 15 or 16,000 taka, so that's really a good deal. Price is always fluctuating, so don't take my words for granted, but one thing I can say, for the money you are getting a good value. Now in this price range you are gonna get some good other phones, like Xiaomi is offering some good phones, Huawei is offering some good phones. It has a huge distribution across the globe and it has a large retail store network, so you can pick this phone in your nearby store and you can use that international warranty wherever you are. So that's a great advantage of Samsung. So it's an easy recommendation. I can easily recommend this phone to you, but this phone also has some flaws. Number one flaw is its speaker quality. It's very tiny and the speaker position is awkward, so in gaming or movie watching you can easily block the speaker with your finger, and this can make the speaker sound disappear.
Ran out of water. finally get the right ratios after making 15 shots of espresso.
So that's a huge drawback. Another little nitpicking flaw I would say is its build quality. Though it feels very tanky or robust in the hand, but due to the plastic construction, this phone might break if you drop it on a hard concrete surface. Anyways, this was my review of the Samsung Galaxy J6. If you like this video, definitely hit the thumbs up button down below. And if you're new in my channel, definitely hit the subscribe button. Anyways, thanks for watching. Stay tuned, stay awesome, and I'll see you guys in the next one.